Abu Dinladi, you see that Ghanaian wristband on his left arm, was playing barefoot about 8 years ago in Ghana, won a trial at the Right to Dream Academy, and eventually making his way all the way here to Westwood.
I come from this town called Anaje in the western part of Ghana. I grew up playing in this like dirt field. I never thought like I would get an opportunity to try out for an actual team.
Keep your eye on the talented Abu Dinladi.
They made an announcement on the radio that there was a soccer academy having a tryout. So I was like, okay, I don't know how I'm gonna get there.
And Dinladi, the freshman, unlocks the defense. The talent of this kid, it's off the charts.
I didn't have money because I didn't even have money for lunch. And one of my friends was like, hey, you know, I can pay for you. I had to sit on his lap because like the bus so that we could pay only one fare. I didn't know anybody there and it was really hard to get into the trial. 5 minutes left, one of the players got hurt, went in, did really well. And at the end of the day, out of everybody who came to the trial, that's like about 300 players. I was like the only one like chosen. My 4 years there, I worked really hard and there was an opportunity to come to the US and they were like, you wanna do this? I thought if I could leave one less burden on my family and it's a great opportunity, I love soccer.
It's been a long time coming for the freshman. He's got the weight of expectations on his shoulders.
I went to school in Los Olivos. My host mom's name was Helena Avery, and my dad is Christopher Avery. First, I was like a little bit shy, and I was in my room for like the first 2 days. I started getting to know them, great family. Everything they've done for me, I don't think money can pay back. So like, all I want to do is like make sure I do well in school and work out on the field and make sure I make them proud.
Chris is an alumni of UCLA, and being the host family of Abu, he obviously was really proud of him and wanted us to know about Abu and want us to be familiar with him as a player. And we started to do some research and start to investigate to what type of player he was. And sure enough, he turned out to be an absolute superstar.
Here come the Bruins. Dinladi! Oh, you betcha! Smooth as silk. Quality shines through. Abu Dinladi putting on quite a show.
I'll never forget the first day that he was in a full practice. I mean, the guys literally wanted to applaud for him because of the technique and his ability. And you can just sense a lift in the group because of the talent and ability that he has. But just more his personality and the way he carries himself and how happy he is when he's on the field and how much joy he has. You know, once we do see him on the field full time, we'll see all the ability that he has.
When I was back home, I noticed a lot of kids who die for this opportunity. That's one of the things that keeps on pushing me every day to do good in class and work really hard on the field. Because if I do that, not only that I represent myself here, I represent my family, I represent my community back home, and I represent Ghana in general. So I always want to do something good, and I always want to work really hard and do something better with my life to go back and help people back home.